Welcome back to Divine Lotus Tarot. We are taking a look at May 2021 for your soulmate love reading for yourself and whoever your love interest is, whether this is someone who you are currently with, someone who you may be considering having a reconciliation with, a former flame or an ex, or someone who hasn't even potentially come into your life, but they're just showing up in your energy field. So we're going to take a look at your perspective, and if we need to just specify in the energies, you'll be person A, and whoever the other individual is, who your love interest is, coming up in your energy, or who you are thinking of, or who you are with, they are going to be person B. So I already got the card shuffled out. Let's go ahead and get into your reading. So your headspace, we have you coming through with the Ace of Swords, okay? Love interest. Ooh, we have them coming through with the Four of Pentacles. So I initially heard greedy with this energy right here. So it looks like maybe you're dealing with someone who's greedy. Now, this is a Pentacles card, so this could be someone who is greedy with their money, greedy with their time. This could be a greedy person who just loves to grub. But whatever it is, it's something that someone really values, that they love to like have an excess of. Okay, so someone loves to be very excessive in some type of manner. This could even be someone who's greedy with you. Okay, so this could be someone who just does not want to let go of you. They could just love to spend a lot of time with you. They could love having all of your undivided attention on them. So I am getting someone who is coming off in a very type of greedy head space at this point in time for whatever reason. Okay, whether it's directed at you or it's with whatever they have of theirs. Okay, and for your head space, we have the Ace of Swords. So I hear I know. So there's something that you could be learning or something that you could be discovering about this individual. This may be some type of secret that is revealed to you, okay, is what I'm getting, because now I'm getting clarity. So there's something that's becoming aware to you that you were not aware of before when it comes to yourself and whoever this is that you are connecting to. Interesting. I keep hearing hoarding. So there's something about this individual hoarding something over here. Interesting. And now I'm hearing light. You're shining a light on something with this individual. Now, I feel like if this is someone who you're with, this could be some type of communication that you're getting to the truth or to the bottom of some type of situation with whoever you are already associated with, connected to, or someone who makes themselves present to you. Okay. If this is not someone that you have come into contact with, then I feel like there's just something that's becoming very clear to you about yourself and this individual, between yourself and this connection, that's being made very blatantly clear to you. So this could be something that you're finding out, and I'm getting something about potentially for some of you, if this is someone who you have not come into contact with, this may have something to do with some type of relationship or connection that this person has with another individual. So in that sense, if this is someone who you have yet to even come into contact with, this is representing someone in this person's energetic field who is coming up in this energy towards them. So this could be something that you're being made aware of, potentially through this reading or through any other means, however you would find that out, for someone who you have yet to come into contact with, okay? So that's what I'm getting at. If this is someone you haven't yet met, this is another person in their energy field. So this is someone being like this towards them. This could be that this other individual's mindset, their energy of just, their outlook, their perspective on life, or their energy towards this person, okay? How you're viewing this individual, we have the Death card. Okay. So I'm hearing Scorpionic energy. Because the Death is represented by Scorpio energy. How they're viewing you, we have the Ace of Wands. Interesting. So I'm hearing Light of Fire. Of Wands, you're coming up with the Ace of Swords, okay? I'm hearing intellect. So, what I'm seeing is, for some of you, they could be feeling some type of spark being lit under them, or within them, to take some type of action. Now, I'm hearing drastic, so they could be feeling prompted to take some type of drastic measure. This could either be because there's something that you're sparking in this individual, or there's just something that is just being sparked within this person themselves. I mean, maybe this is them coming into the realization of whoever this other person is that they're dealing with. And I was getting like third party energy, so that could be anyone. This could be family, this could be friends, this could be people that they work with, because I'm hearing there's something to do with obligations, or this could be someone else who they have some type of financial obligation to, okay? Potentially someone who they were even or are in a relationship with. So yeah, I just see them being prompted to take some type of action towards another individual. There's some type of spark, and it's being driven. They're being driven to do this because it has something to do with how they feel about you. Okay. Now, if this is someone that you're already dealing with, I just feel like there's something that you've awakened in this individual that they're now seeing that maybe that they weren't aware of before, or maybe that they just weren't ready to just acknowledge or deal with. Because the Four of Pentacles can also talk about someone who like keeps things to themselves, keeps things close to the chest, keeps things hidden. So if this is someone like, let's say that you are aware of, or you already have some type of connection to, this could be something that someone has been like really holding on for a really long time and not wanting to let go of. For some of you, this could be some type of grudge, whether this is some type of grudge towards you, or this is just some type of grudge that this person has been holding on to, you know, when it comes to just life experiences that they've dealt with. Like, say for instance, that they've had terrible relationships prior to being with you, and every relationship, you know, since whatever negative experience that they've had, they've always carried some type of, you know, energetic resonance with them that they never fully like released or let go of. I'm hearing burden. So someone has been holding on to something and just going from connection to connection, or just, you know, essentially continuing to move through life without ever really addressing these issues. So it's like this person has just been holding on to this, and it's just been some type of like burden on this person. And because it's a burden on them, they, you know, essentially are going to bring a burden into any type of connection or relationship that they have, where someone is wanting to open up to them and have them open back up and get close to them. So it's like, it's hard for this person to let down their guard or fully trust or fully open, because they're still, they had been still holding on to all of this. But I feel there's something with you that is causing this person to want to like release this, is what I'm seeing. Like they're feeling some type of spark of like change or hope within them that they feel they want to finally let this go. This could even be like sharing something with you that they've always held on to, that they never shared with anyone else because they never felt safe or secure enough. This is what I'm seeing right here. This is someone who doesn't feel safe, so they're really guarded. Okay, so I was also getting some type of energy of venom, which is also like a Scorpio type of reference, venom. So I was getting something about, like, I heard venomous, and I even had to excuse myself because I had to get up and like I had to spit. Okay. So there is some type of venomous type of like poison that this person has been like holding on to, or it's something that this person has been holding on to that has turned to like a venomous type of poison either within them or causing them to like act in a certain type of manner towards people in this manner. And I'm getting scorpionic references because I feel like Scorpios sting and they have venom in their tail. But I mean, it could be, you know, any other type of whatever, you know, animal that has, you know, venomous type of traits about them. But Scorpio is what comes to me, especially because, you know, you have the death card energy over here, how you're seeing this person. So that's another reference right there that some of you could be dealing with someone who is a Scorpio or has significant Scorpio type of placements in their birth chart. So this could be, like I was saying, someone essentially just feeling like they finally are at a point in their life because they feel comfortable with you, or you have made them aware of something that they want to share something with you. They feel like they want to open up, okay, is what I'm getting. So you could be initiating some type of conversation with this person that gets this individual in this frame of mind that makes them feel this way, or it could just be essentially something that you say that just awakens something in this person, okay? Because we have you seeing this person with the death card, so this is some type of major significant like transformation right here that you're I'm hearing that you're undertaking, but it's also something that you are seeing within this person as well too. So maybe some type of change in perspective is going to occur with the way you view this person after they reveal to you whatever it is that they've either been holding back from you specifically, or just that they have been holding in all of this time that they've never shared with anyone else. So it seems like whatever this person reveals to you is going to really give you a new perspective and outlook on this individual. Now, the death card is major. So for some of you, this is going to be very significant, whatever this is. Whatever this conversation is. It seems very intense, it seems heavy, it seems very deep, it seems very emotional, okay? But I'm getting very guarded energy with this individual, and you're seeing something, and I'm getting flash, so something could be changing, like, very quickly. Like, your life could be changing very quickly. Your perception of this connection or this person could change and shift very quickly. Okay? Because the death means something has to die off. Whatever was old that is no longer of use cannot move forward into this next new phase or stage. After death, there is rebirth. Okay? So we have birth, death, and then the rebirth cycle. So for some of you, this definitely could be someone who you are rekindling a situation with, okay? It could be. But what I'm definitely picking up is that whatever this is, your perception of this person has changed, okay? And we have the Four of Pentacles for their headspace. The death card is number 13, which simplifies to a 4. So the 4s talk about structure, the 4s talk about security, the 4s talk about stability. So I'm just trying to go over in my mind and see very quickly all of the cards in the tarot deck that have 4 in them. The Minor Arcana. We have the Four of Swords, the Four of Pentacles, the Four of Cups, and then the Four of Wands. I feel like for some of you, this is definitely some, okay, for some of you, this could be someone from the past. That's what I'm getting. It could be someone coming back from the past. For others of you, this could be someone, because I'm getting some type of life cycle here with this death card. I'm getting literally the birth, the death, and the rebirth. So there, this seems like there is something that was initially started, something ended, and something is going to restart again. So that's why I'm getting there's a past energy here for some of you. For others of you, this is just someone who maybe you and this individual could have been on separate, you know, life experiences. You come into each other's life, and now you're going through this next new phase of your life together, which is the rebirth stage. So you, some of you all may both, okay, both of you may be coming from situations where you've had very drastic shifts and change in your life, especially, I'm hearing cataclytic, hold on, let me look that up. Okay, I think the word that was coming through is cataclysmic, and I looked it up, the definition is relating to or denoting a violent natural event, used to emphasize the extent of something bad or unwelcome. So I feel like for some of you, if this is a new individual, both of you have went through some very significant shifts and changes in your romantic and love life, but I'm getting something to do with, like, divorce. That's what I was going to say. I feel like both of you may have went through divorces, and it really, like, either the divorce process for both of you, or either one of you was very grueling, long, difficult, or it could just have been the fact that either both or either one of you went through this experience, it like significantly impacted you and changed and shifted your life. So that it could be that as well too, okay? So yeah, it could just be something very significant that forever changed your lives with both of you going through some type of separation, divorce, or loss, okay? But the divorce energy was coming through very strongly. So I feel like for some of you, you've had very significant, like, painful, like, endings, or you took it very hard. You went through some type of breakup, separation, or some type of divorce, is what I'm picking up. If this is two individuals coming together for the first time who have never in this lifetime come together. Now, there also may be some type of past life connection here for those of you where this is a new connection where you're coming together with this individual, because once again, we have the birth, death, rebirth. So I'm getting, if this is someone who you have never been with and have never known, then there is something with a tie to a past life connection that the two of you have, and now you're coming back together from something you initially started, okay? And I feel like this is going to be a very significant relationship connection for you all, and there's going to be a very intense, deep connection and bond as well. Let's move on. So as far as what's blocking you from this connection, we do have the Ace of Cups, okay? So you have the Ace of Swords, which is your headspace, and what's blocking you is the Ace of Cups. Both of these talk about brand new beginnings, okay? Having opportunities to take advantage of something being presented to you, and it's really up to you if you take that option or that opportunity or not. What is being presented to you, okay? And then what's blocking this individual, we have the Nine of Cups. Now the interesting thing is, we have the Nine of Cups, what's blocking this person, the Ace of Cups, what's blocking you. When we put those two together, that is a Ten of Cups, which is the happily ever after card. That is true love, harmonious, blissful, romantic connection, relationship, a happy home, feeling blessed, feeling just emotionally, positively overwhelmed with your loved ones, your family, your man, your wife, your children, you know what I'm saying? Or someone who you could see yourself building a life and having a family with. I'm saying? Someone who you do have that strong emotional attachment and connection to in a healthy manner, where it's balanced and it's reciprocated on both sides, okay? So the interesting thing is, it's like the two of you are the missing pieces to each other's puzzle. That's why I'm saying, for some of you, this is an opportunity to revisit a situation from the past. And what would be blocking you all in that instance is, I mean, it's here for the taking. I feel like in this instance, because I'm getting the past energy and a new energy, some of you may have a significant decision to make when it comes to two people who may be coming back to you, or not even back. Well, yeah, technically, it would be two people coming back to you, because it would be someone who you've been with in this lifetime and then someone from a past life. And then for others of you, I just feel like you may have an opportunity with someone from your past, okay? And I mean, that's up to you if you decide to take it or not. Like, here is a window of opportunity being presented for the two of you to have the option to reconcile and move forward and start over if you so choose to. But for some of you, there is a sense of blocked emotions or your heart space when it comes to wanting to give out and filter love to this connection, is what I'm seeing, especially if this is someone who you've already been with, okay? Because I'm hearing it's a lot of damage that has already been done from this previous connection. So someone could be coming back, you know, pouring out their heart to you, or expressing something to you that they've never shared with you before. And some of you, you know, may not know how to necessarily receive this because of the person and because of the amount of time and maybe the amount of things that have been done, right? And then for others of you, this is going to be a situation where you have two people who are pulling at your heartstrings. And you're going to have to make the decision of who you're going to go with, okay? I'm getting very strongly it's going to be a person from the past and someone new. But in other instances, it could just be two amazing, wonderful individuals who are coming into some of you all's life. And, you know, you just have to decide, who do you want to be with? Now, as far as whoever this is you're connecting with the Nine of Cups over here, I just feel like what's blocking them is essentially the ball maybe in a lot of you all's court, because this person sees you, you know, as someone who is their wish fulfillment. So if this is someone coming back from the past, I mean, it's going to be up to you if you want to entertain this person. If you have two amazing, wonderful individuals who are wanting to pursue you, then it's going to be up to you which person you select. Someone's going to have to get their feelings hurt. I mean, unless you all decide to make some type of arrangement where you can have both of them, or all of them, however many people this is. But, I mean, that would just essentially be that situation. Whoever this person is over here, the ball is going to be in your court, and they know this, okay? But they definitely see you as their wish fulfillment. Now, as far as the action that the two of you want to take towards each other, we do have the Prince of Cups over here on your side, and then this individual, y'all see that, the Four of Wands. And what was I just talking about earlier when I said the Four energy? The Four of Pentacles, the Death card, which symbolized to a four, and now we have the Four of Wands out here. Four, four, four. Okay, so that number is going to be very significant for some of you all. But as far as the action that the two of you are wanting to take towards each other, I'm seeing there is love on the table for whoever you decide to move towards, okay? So as of right now, I'm not necessarily really getting the old person or the new person who you're selecting. I'm just essentially getting the action that you're going to take is going to be towards the person who holds your heart. You're going to give your cup to the person you feel that gush in you for. So that's the step that you're gonna take. Whoever you feel that sense of emotional security, that emotional fulfillment, that emotional safety with, that emotional connection with, that is who you're moving towards. And this person is seeing themselves wanting to settle down and commit to you. They are ready to give you whatever you want, essentially. And for some of you, this is the two of you taking it to the next level in your relationship. Or essentially some of you getting married, okay? So this person could be proposing to some of you all, is what I'm getting. But I'm getting something about things moving quickly. So whoever you decide to move forward with, it looks like things are going to take off very quickly. And then the potential outcome, if the two of you actually, the best likely potential outcome, if the two of you follow through with these actions that you're taking, we have the Two of Pentacles, and I'm hearing move. So there's going to be some type of situation that calls for the two of you to have to move. Now, whether this is because the two of you live on two different, I'm hearing like East Coast. So I don't know if the two of you live on two different points of the East Coast, or where someone lives on the East Coast, someone lives on the West Coast, or it's just the fact that there is distance between the two of you, so you're going to have to try to figure out, okay, how or where you are going to compromise, okay? But this also could just be signifying the two of you are going to be buying a home together, and you're just trying to figure out, you know, where are you going to plant your roots? Because we got the fours out here. The fours represent the fourth home. The fourth house in your astrological, you know, makeup of the zodiac houses. The fourth house represents home. It represents your roots. Okay, so this could just be talking about also broadly where the two of you are going to plant roots at. Even if you live in the same area, it could just be some of you maybe feeling like you want to move and relocate somewhere else. That's going to be better for the both of you, you know, to give you a fresh, brand new start. Or if the two of you are in two different areas and locations, even regions, I'm getting, then you're going to need to compromise and come to some resolve about where you two want to settle down and plant roots. That's going to be the best for you all. I'll clarify the Two of Pentacles and then we'll wrap it up. The Ace of Pentacles. Clarify the Two of Pentacles. So I'm getting planning. So there's some type of planning going on here. Whether this is the two of you planning this wedding, or this is making plans to, like I said, relocate towards each other, making plans to see each other, whether this is making plans to purchase a home. But I'm seeing some type of planning energy and the two of you like coming together. I'm hearing conspire. So I feel like the two of you are going to come together, like put your heads together, and you're going to work together to come to some type of happy resolve in this situation. But whatever it is, it's going to produce something very tangible that something tangible. So whatever the two of you are coming together, I'm getting joining forces, that you're coming together to do is going to, now I'm hearing make money. So this could also be work related as well too, for some of you. So this could be some type of business as well too. Maybe the two of you are going to go into business together. Maybe the two of you are going to invest in something together, because I'm hearing cooperate. But whatever it is, it's going to require like working together in a team, collaborative type of energy between you and this individual. I'm hearing partnering. I'm hearing membership. So I don't know if this is the type of business that you guys are into, or that you're creating, or this is this is two peas in a pod. These are two people that move the same way. So maybe this is just essentially you and this individual. You're good business partners, you know what I'm saying? And lovers. Or maybe it starts as business and then the two of you become lovers. But either way, I'm seeing the two of you link up, join forces together, and something is going, it's going to produce something very tangible, okay? That's going to really pay off in the long run. But those are all of the messages that I have for you.